What you're about to see isn't your average video. It's a record of a special event for staff and friends of TAS TV.
We've set out to please as many people and interests as possible.
For instance, we know you train buffs like to hear all of the wonderful sounds of the steam era. So where possible, we've refrained from talking over and spoiling your special scenes.
For kids young and old, there's Humphrey and there's lots of him.
For those who travelled with us, we've included as many of you as possible.
So sit back, relax and enjoy the great TAS TV train rides remembered.
In 1960, TAS TV, then TVT6, pioneered the television industry in Tasmania with shows like these. In 1975, the magic of colour was introduced to our screens. Two decades later, another chapter in history, television aggregation. To symbolise the first day of statewide broadcasts, TAS TV took the show on the road, or at least by rail. Personalities and popular programmes transported and transmitted to new audiences in a unique way. It's an early start to the day with a sausage sizzle breakfast hosted by the cartoon company's Craig Farrell, an enthusiastic train buff, as is his sidekick Boss Poss, one of two furry stars of the day.
All along the bike track. If you're on the bike track, you'll see us. We'll be in the big blue train going along the bike track. You can't miss it.
The Hobart train and another from the northwest coast will act as mobile studios for Saturday morning's locally produced programs, Cartoon Company and Big Music Soup. The show's personalities will record crosses to entertain viewers at home and help make them part of the day too. Volunteers from Derwent Valley Railways carefully backed their once derelict but now lovingly restored engine into the rail yard. There's plenty of interest in the coupling of the carriages to the grand old H2 loco. Almost ready now for the first leg of the journey, and then comes the final call for all aboard.
We're in the canteen. This is where the food is, the like food. The sangers and the most, you know, all the lollies. The yes, and it's all fully. It's like a real place. I mean, just because it's a train, we've got Christine behind there, like at the canteen. We've got at work. We've got Alice behind the canteen. And look at these things. These are fantastic. These are blinking signal lights. See? Yeah, they blink, blink, and then ding, 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 ding as you go across. On the northwest coast, the TAS TV flyer is revealed to the public. Travelling on board will be a certain bear that's already starting to attract some attention, as well as the Big Music Soup's Paul Franklin and Fee from Triple T.
Hello Tasmania, we are on the TAS TV flyer. My name's Paul Franklin from Big Music Soup my colleague.
Yeah, Fee, Filthy Fee, whatever you want to call me.
And we're going to travel on this train all the way to Launceston. We're in Wynyard at the moment.
Yeah, we
it's
are.
Very cold this morning.
Yeah, it's freezing. I've got a cold, but it's good for me. The steam's great. Oh, Humphrey, I've got to
Most important of all.
Oh, yeah, Humphrey.
Our favourite bear, Humphrey. How's it going, Hump?
Hi, Hump. Bree, I got a kiss.
You like it when you kiss on the nose, don't you?
Bridgewater, the Derwent Valley Railway's loco which has brought us this far, is not permitted any further. So say hello to a new engine, MA2, dubbed the TAS TV Express and crewed by Devonport's Don River Railway.
City, Bernie, and the train has just pulled up. A few people have got off just to have a few drinks. We're going all the way to Launceston, which is that way. Lonnie's that way. Bernie's here. Rest of the world's over here. Hello, Fiona. How are you? Bit of decoration.
Look what I've written. My big music suit. You can catch it from 10:30 to 12 today. It's our show, music videos and everything like that.
Another of many crosses for Big Music Soup. But the arrival of the flyer also heralds the opening to the public of TAS TV's new Bernie Studios. And again, Humphrey steals the show.
Thank you. Oh, come on. No, from Jared. No,
from you.
Oh, Humphrey.
There you go. Move this way, Humphrey.
Our travellers from the south are now enjoying some insights into television courtesy of the cartoon company.
Aren't we having a lovely time?
Yeah.
Progress report, we've changed locomotives, you saw that before, we've changed locomotives, we're now behind MA2, right, which is a little bit different. H2 brought us to Bridgewater very successfully.
Yes.
And then we swapped over and we're going with MA2.
Yep.
You might have noticed that...
Chopping along.
Yeah, well, you noticed that we've got a red locomotive now as
yes,
opposed to a blue one.
Blue one.
Yeah, so there we go. We've had a colour change here.
Pushed a message.
Always keeping up to date with colour. Now, are you guys having fun in the big voice? Yeah, see, they're all having fun, having a lovely time, and we're having a lovely time too.
Oh, yeah.
And we've had a look out the window and we've got cinders in our eye. Fantastic. Just keeping you up to date and we'll see you later.
The Express is now building up a big head of steam and it'll need it for the long climb ahead.
Things are pretty exciting here at the moment because pacing us out the window in the sky is Tom Payne in a helicopter. And we're all
chopper.
Excited, aren't we?
Yeah.
Let's wave to Tom.
Hi, Tom.
There he goes. And I think he's... Oh, he's not meant to land there. Anyway, we'll find out what's happening to
meant
Tom.
Meant to be spinning
Look,
like that?
He is, yeah. And we're all having fun, aren't we, Warren?
Yes.
There we go. Look, we'll go because the man's talking and telling us where we are.
Yeah.
And we'll see you later.
Ta-da. Well,
everything running to schedule, but back at the studios, staff are working at a hectic pace to relay recorded segments from both of the trains into the lounge rooms of viewers across the state. The township of Penguin is out in force to greet the flyer, and word seems to be spreading quickly along the coast that Humphrey is on board.
Do you want to kiss him on the nose?
Can I just pose a question here about the name?
A possum. I'm being interviewed by a possum.
Music soup. Now, Tim, you might know the answer to this.
He finds it amusing too.
The big music part I'm fine with, but soup, what's the connection with music and food?
Well, you see, we thought that, that's a trick question.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, well, listen, who's this music critic, you might be saying to yourself, you Northern Tasmanian and Western Tasmanian viewers for the first time? This is Tim Franklin. Now, he's your brother, Paul Franklin.
Which one's the possum?
This one.
Oh, yeah.
I'm the possum.
I get confused.
This is Tim.
I'm the furry.
This is Tim. Now, if you're wondering what Tim does, Tim is on with a little guides, how to live properly and eat and do all those things and what you can see in Tasmania, right? So he'll be on after music soup, so stay tuned for that.
Gig guy. Well, listen, I've got to say, I've never been interviewed by a possum before. This is big.
It is big. He's never been interviewed by Tim Franklin before either, and he's excited.
Next stop on the map, Ulverston. And by this time, everyone on the flyer is convinced Humphrey B. Bear should run for Prime Minister. As you can see, he has all the right qualifications, shaking hands and kissing babies.
Hello. This one likes Humphrey.
G'day, Humphrey.
No, she doesn't want Humphrey.
Hey, Sebastian!
Everything going to plan on the flyer, but trouble lays ahead for the express after it was to make its last stop before the big climb. As the flyer pulls out of Devonport, it continues making good time, bumping along the tracks as the world outside appears to roll by. It's a motion that rekindles memories for an older generation, and one which provides something new and unique for the young. Making the trip on the express more enjoyable, volunteers from Derwent Valley Railway and TAS TV pitching in to play waiter for the day. Meanwhile, other personalities join me in the opportunity to mingle.
Is there any spare seats anywhere on
the Yes, sir. Little did we know, for half our passengers, it was going to turn into a very long businessman's lunch.
Your attention, please. This is a fairly major situation that we've reached that here. What we're going to do is we're going to split the train in half. Carriages at the rear of the train, that is carriages 4 and 5, will be remaining here, well braked, parking brake firmly on, and the remainder of the train will be going on until we get to Parramatta. The engine will then go back and pick up the second half of the train. It looks as though that's the only way that we can get up this gradient. So I'd like you to bear with us and look forward to letting you know exactly what's happening shortly.
And what happens? This time, with its lighter load, the express easily makes it up the troublesome gradient, heading for the darkness of Rindaston Tunnel. But you wouldn't believe it, we've left the batteries on the other half of the train. So no lights and an impromptu carols by candlelight.
Here we come out of the tunnel now, so we made it. We did manage to rescue the band onto this half of the train, so there will be plenty of time for relaxation and listening to jazz while the engine disconnects itself.
Goes back to fetch the second half of the train. At Parramatta, the full body of the Youth Festival show band started warming up for some trackside entertainment, while railway volunteers worked quickly to uncouple the engine for the dash back to pick up the rest of our train. Parramatta used to be the major line stop for lunch and a bustling railway station. Today, the steam train, hundreds of passengers and a big band brought to the township the sort of activity it hadn't seen for a long time. Unfortunately, the doors of the local pub closed many years ago. No delays for the Northwest Flyer, living up to its name and literally flying along. And just like the Southern train, it's one big party, made all the better for the young train fans by the presence of an almost 2-metre-tall, friendly, furry TV star. At last, the express is back to join the rest of the train at Parramatta. Our railway crew has been working double time to get us on the way again, and the grand old MA2 locomotive has also been put to the test, as the soot-covered flag shows. The revelry continues, with volunteers working overtime to keep up the supply of balloons while they bounce their way through the Midlands. However, the delays were causing concerns for one woman. Her family waiting in Launceston would be worried. Never fear, it's modern technology to the rescue.
Hey, make a phone call.
Hello, ma'am.
Some of us had now gone ahead by chopper to Launceston, leaving Tim in the dark.
Let me ask you, Anna, what's been the highlight of your train trip today? What's been the best thing that's happened?
When we stopped for a long time and we had to split the carriages apart.
How long do you think we stopped for? It was fabulous though, wasn't it?
Yeah, about 3 hours.
Was it that long? I would never have known it was 3 hours, let me tell you. What about you, Gemma? What's been the highlight for you today?
When we kept on riding before we stopped and we tried to get up the hill.
And what's your favourite show on Taz TV?
Hey, hey.
Let me ask you, what's your favourite television station altogether?
Taz TV!
A very quick stopover in Deloraine to top up the engine with water. Humphrey stays on board but continues to win hearts and to prove he's a one-bear entertainment dynamo. Historic Ross, and a chance for the Express to also take on water. Everyone knows the unforeseen delays mean we'll miss aggregation action in Launceston. Did someone mention aggravation? Not on this train ride. David, are you having a good time?
We're having a great time, Tim.
What's been the highlight of your day, David?
Well, I think just the relaxed atmosphere of the whole trip. I mean, you know, how else could you take, you know, from 7:45 in the morning until 6 o'clock at night to see Tasmania's countryside? It's fantastic.
You know, David, we stopped today for 3 hours just for you.
I know that, Tim. I really appreciate that. It's been great.
Now, we've just left. We should be in Launceston in round about 1 hour's time. When we arrive in Launceston, what are you going to do with yourself?
Well, we were going out to the studios, but a couple of hiccups with the trip means that's been cancelled. That's the only disappointing aspect of the day. We've had a great day. We'll bus back in style. Compliments of Taz Television, and we've had a great day. We just enjoyed it.
Taz TV.
Flyer is making one of its last stops and still creating plenty of excitement. Our camera crew also attract attention. Maybe these kids are some of the stars of tomorrow. Then again, maybe not. Well, we're Launceston bound and full steam ahead on the express through the fast and flat Midlands. Up above, our progress is being monitored by the eye in the sky, the Taz TV chopper. Meanwhile, at the Launceston studios, celebrations are in full swing.
We'll say it again. We're still number one, still making friends.
Still the show.
The Flyer arrives on time, with its complement of Northwest passengers ready to be whisked away to King's Meadows to tour the studios and meet the stars. And the Southern train now making good time. Katrina, what's been the highlight of your day as we dock in Launceston?
You don't want me to tell you?
Yeah, I do. That's why I asked. The long stay.
The long stay where we had lunch. It was a lovely part of the world. I don't know exactly where it was, but it was beautiful.
The Graham, have you had a top day or what?
It's been a fantastic day. We had a lot of fun and it's nice to ride in a train again.
When was the last time you rode in a train?
Oh, many, many years ago, but it's too long ago to remember, but it's been nice today.
Have you had a good day?
I've had a wonderful day, thanks very much, yeah.
What's been the highlight?
Oh, I reckon that wait up there near Rinderston, we sort of got to know everyone pretty well, and it's just been a wonderful day, and who can get onto a train every time of any day of the week?
Hi, Tim, how did you like this trip?
I thought it was fantastic. I think it's the best train ride I've ever had in my life.
What's your favourite station?
I'd have to say, can I think about it? No, I'd have to say Taz TV. Yep, Taz TV, still number one in my books.
Same with me.
Ian, I need to know, did the teddy bear have a good day today?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Where's the teddy bear?
Here!
What television station does the teddy watch?
Let me think. Play school. Home Paddy Show. We've said it before.
Well, it's better late than never. The express finally chips into town. We hear, but the main party is over and the stars have moved on to Burnie to be part of Hey Hey It's Saturday. Time for more improvisation, the hallmark of our day. It's onto the buses and before some of us head back to Hobart, we're ferried across town for another impromptu party. And after a special tour of the studios, it's pizza time. All in all, a great day with a few hiccups along the way, but as they say, that's showbiz. Lucky someone didn't break a leg. For those staying overnight, it was back on the train tomorrow for more steam adventure.